In this example, we use the heating curve of benzene to determine the energy needed for a temperature and phase change of benzene. Our problem reads, how much heat is required to convert 125 milliliters liquid benzene at 22 degrees Celsius to benzene at 96 degrees Celsius? The heat capacity of liquid and gaseous benzene are 1.726 and 1.055 joules per gram degree Celsius, respectively. The enthalpy of fusion and vaporization for benzene are 9.90 and 30.8 kilojoules per mole, respectively. The melting and boiling points of benzene are 5.4 degrees Celsius and 80.1 degrees Celsius. The density of liquid benzene is 0.8765 grams per milliliter. The molar mass of benzene is 78.11 grams per mole. We can start by mapping out the heating curve for the temperature change we're interested in. We're starting at 22 degrees Celsius, which is between the melting and boiling points of benzene, so we're starting with a liquid. Our first step is to increase the temperature of the benzene to its boiling point. Once we reach the boiling point, the added heat no longer increases the temperature of the liquid. Instead, the thermal energy goes into the vaporization process. So our second step is to vaporize benzene, changing it from a liquid to a gas. Once all of the liquid benzene has been vaporized, our third step is to increase the temperature of the gaseous benzene to 96 degrees Celsius. When we increase the temperature of a substance, we use the equation heat equals mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature to calculate the energy needed to change the temperature of a substance. We can calculate the mass of benzene from its volume using dimensional analysis and the given density. The density allows us to convert from milliliters of benzene to grams of benzene. We should have 109.6 grams benzene. Then we can plug our mass, specific heat capacity, and change in temperature into our equation. Completing the calculation, we should get 10,990 joules. Next, we need to vaporize benzene. We're given the enthalpy of vaporization in kilojoules per mole, which we can use as a conversion factor in dimensional analysis to convert between moles of benzene and energy. We'll start the dimensional analysis with 125 milliliters benzene. We can convert from milliliters to grams using the density, then from grams to moles benzene using the molar mass given in the problem. Then we convert from moles benzene to kilojoules using the enthalpy of vaporization. Completing the calculation, we get 43.20 kilojoules. Our third step is to increase the temperature of benzene from 80.1 degrees Celsius to 96 degrees Celsius. We'll use Q equals mc delta T again. Plugging in the mass we calculated earlier, the specific heat capacity for gaseous benzene, and the change in temperature, we should get 1,838 joules. The last thing we need to do is sum the energy from each step. We will convert all of our units to kilojoules so we can add them together. So 10,990 joules in step 1 becomes 10.99 kilojoules, and 1,838 joules in step 3 becomes 1.838 kilojoules. Completing the addition, we get 50.03 kilojoules.